Hey, this is Jen with Glasses, and we're back, and I'm playing Freddy Pharkas, Frontier Pharmacist. Okay, so hopefully this server will do well. I've had a lot of problems tonight being kicked off. I don't know. Oh, come on. Alright, we're just gonna play. Alright, let's try it and see if it works. Sorry guys, you missed me getting the pie and the gun cleaning kit, but hopefully you won't miss the minigame, so... Unless it freezes up again, in which case you will, which it's doing. Craptastic! Come on! Alright, so that's working now. Alright. Alright, let's just see what we can do. You know, it used to be Thursday nights. Now it's switched over to Monday nights that are a tough night, technically. I don't know why. No one can tell me. Alright, so here we go. We're gonna give him our... Well, we have the... What do we have to do? I think we just have to talk to him and he'll tell us what to do. Here we go. Welp, Serena, I think I'm getting ready to try some target shooting. You ready? Of certainly, I am without a desire to wait any further to stand in front of your blazing guns and take my life in your hands to help you perfect your shooting. How do you want to start? Perhaps it would be best if you place some targets upon the fence post for a commencement. Alright, so let's quick save it again. Save! Okay, let's replace this. Replace just real quick, because I have a feeling this minigame's not going to turn out so great. So we'll see. I think last time before I blew up, it gave me a chance to, like... oh, we're back. It already saved it already. Fast! It gave me a chance to pick the level of difficulty. I did not pick the toughest level because I know myself. Here we go. There's no point in setting up target practice until you're ready to start shooting. How am I not ready? Oh, I didn't load the bullets in. Gotta load the bullets in. In case you missed that part of the puzzle. You slip the bullets in the chamber. All of your old memories come running back to you. Even the ones about you and your first cousin. Oh, good gravy. No thank you, game. We did mention this is the same guy who wrote this as wrote Leisure Suit Larry, right? Because this is gross. Sometimes. Provided you are prepared to practice shooting, set the bottles upon the fence post and we can commence to begin shooting. Sorry, I was trying to. I didn't mean to hit you. Okay, I gotta back it up. Back it up. Here we go. Go ahead, make our day.
I'm one bad hombre. Do your worst. I'm feeling pretty tough, but don't bust my chops. I've had too much tequila last night. Go easy.
I don't know. Should I try it on the toughest first and just see how I do? I have it saved. Like, what's it gonna do? Okie the dokie, Freddy Pharkas. First, we shall see if you can successfully strike the bottles from afar with the bullets of your pistol. Then, I will toss the bottles up in the air and you may try to hit them in flight. Oh, boy. Good luck, and may the best man win. Okay, where is he? Okay, this thing's also... Whoa! This is moving... Like, this is not my hand moving it. This is it's moving of its own accord. So this is what they mean. Oh, you... Okay, this is too tough. This is already way too tough. It's too tough. I should have picked this one. There we go. I was aiming for this when I hit the other one. That is a bad sign, guys. Can you, please. There we go.
Score!
I did it. Oh no, what's he doing? Oh no. Nope, I need to take this down a level. It's going over here, I know, but still. Ah! record, like, hand off, it's still moving around. That's part of their thing. Got one! There's no more scrub tree left, but I just need like a butt shotgun. Sawed off shotgun. Not precision weapons. Shouldn't I have two since I have 2 6 shooters? I have shot way more than the bullets I have, I'm pretty sure. Nope, this is bad. This is really bad. Always going to the same place. This is not going the same place, that's for sure. Okay, I'm just going to try and get the circle. If I can just get the circle around the way. Nope. Yeah! 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 Woo! Here we go. Alright. Nope. Got excited too quickly. Yes! I know I'm doing terribly, but I'm still excited. Yeah!
Score!
I did it. Very good, Freddy Pharkas. Let us try some quick drawing. Just make sure you hit the target and not me. Oh no! Our friend's life is in our hands, guys. This is a terrible idea. Okay. Oh, I didn't watch what he was doing. There we go. I'm plotting inside myself. Now for the big challenge of all. 6 balls at once. Are they crazy? Oh, I did it! I shouldn't have. They gave it to me. They basically decided I was terrible. I think they kept lowering the levels and went on. I say, Freddy Pharkas, you are not so bad after all this shooting gig. Why, thanks, Serena. My life and the lives of every man, woman, and ruminant in this town depend on my being quick with a gun. Did you not mention earlier that your life is in danger most forthcoming? Something like that. Might I then suggest you might be excellent to placing a disguise upon your person, therefore making appearances that Freddy Pharkas is no longer around this locality? Good thinking, Serini. I need a disguise of some sort, something that will strike terror into the hearts of the bad guys. I know, a bat. I'll disguise myself as a bat, and you can be Serini, the boy wonder. Have you got leotards? Pardon me for asserting, but this bat thing is really hokey. You're right, too juvenile. Let's see, how about... Might I suggest a skin-tight costume with flowing cape, placed upon the manly chest thereof a large F for Pharkas? No, that'd never work. I don't want people to know I'm Freddy, remember? Then perhaps you will need to do something about that right ear, or rather, the lack of that right ear. Dang it, you're right. Everyone knows me as the one-eared pharmacist. I need to make a new one somehow. Maybe forge one out of metal or something. Or make it out of wax, which we have in our inventory. I'll give it some thought and meet you back at the pharmacy once I've completed my disguise. There we go. That's it. Anything else we need to talk to him about? Serenit, what are you waiting for? You! The soonest you can arrange a disguisement of your right ear and complete an outfit most befitting of a gunslinger type person, the soonest we can get you dressed. Alright, so let's save it. I am pretty proud of myself, guys. That was pretty good gunslinging. Especially since it was terrible. Alright, so we gotta find that ear. Find that ear. I have fimmed. That's one way to put it. There we go. This sort of sounds like the Charlie Brown theme. Dun, dun, dun. Switching out my tea. Getting my other tea. Getting a tea leaf down my throat. Alright. So. I need to heat this up. So how do I heat up the earwax? Oh, should I just put it on the... Over here they have candles at the church. Should I just put it on the candles and heat it up on that? I mean, I haven't been able to go into this church at all, so... Other than to get the wax, which is now earwax. Okay, let's see if we can heat this up on here. You trying an old hot wax treatment? You're supposed to have hairy legs, Freddy. No, I'm trying to... Yeah, it does work like that. If it's hot enough, it just doesn't work like that. Okay, I could heat it up in my own thing at home. I have that alcohol lamp. You think I could just heat up on that? Alright, I think I wonder if I tried to manipulate that before. It might not. I think I have tried to use the wax on my alcohol lamp before, but it hasn't let me. But I'm also gonna guess that that's because I didn't need a fake ear before now. Hi, Serene. How'd you get here so fast? You return! Yep. It's good to look upon you. Oh, the same thing they always say. Yeah, I missed you too. We're friends. Except I don't pay you and force you to work all hours of the day for me. And also risk your life. Well, I guess he does pay him. He did work out a salary. It's just he works really long hours. I'm getting worried for him. Alright. We don't get to make medicines right now, but maybe we can make an ear. Okay, so... Let's move this thing over here. Let's light this puppy up. Alright. Personally, I think we should do this. There we go. Oop. That doesn't work like that. Yes, it does. Yes, it. All you have to do is melt it a little bit. You just have to... Okay, is there something... Okay. Alright, what is... This is a test tube. Alright, can I put the wax in the test tube? Come on, game. Does crucible melt things, or is it just... That doesn't work like that. Okay, well, let's try... How do we get things to get... Oh, gosh. Of course, I don't remember. There's nothing inside that crucible to melt, is there? Well, soon there will be. The crucible is only for melting pure or almost pure metals. Oh. I can't melt... Am I supposed to make an ear out of metal? That just seems like a terrible idea. Everyone would know it's a fake ear. The perfect thing to make this out of... Can I crush this up? Is wax. Because you can make it kind of look like an ear. And if he's got a big hat on and a big bandana, no one would know. Okay. Okay. Let me think. Did you just let me? Like, why can't... Crucible? Beaker? Break it up? This game would let me come up with my own solutions. I think I'd be great. Bum, 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 bum. I wish they would give us more ice cream related solutions since we have an ice cream shop right over there. Bum. Mind the store, Serena. I'm off to uphold justice and stuff. Okie dokie. Stupid. There we go. I was gonna say my stream is locked up again, but it's back. Alright, so we need something. Here's what I'm assuming, because when I looked at this wax a billion times, I almost want to call it an ear. It always says the same thing. A puddle of candle wax from the church, suitable for chewing. Trouble is, it loses that church flavor in only a couple minutes. And then when you try and manhandle, it goes, you try to mold the wax with your bare hands, but the wax is a bit too stiff to handle. Oh, Matt. Thank you, sir. Alright, so... Need to warm it up. Where can I warm it up? Well, let me check the barbershop first. Barber. Hey! Alright, so he's still singing. Is there anything new over here? Cabinet contains boring tonsorial equipment. NO2. I kind of like that cabinet. And this guy's just a... sits patiently waiting for his turn in the chair. Sal Crick's licking the baby. Okay, so it's not helpful. Not helpful. Same stuff as last time. Alright, let me see what's going on over here. Help yourself. I'll be right out. He has not been out here one time. All right. So Willie's whittling. Maybe Willie could whittle me an ear.
Score!
Oh, I didn't think that was going to work. Willie, I'm in need of a way to disguise my ear. Do you think you could do something creative with this, perhaps in the shape of an ear, perhaps? Offhand, I'd say. Do it your dang self. My nap time's coming up shortly. I've had a hard day of whittling. But you could maybe do some lost wax casting with the sucker to do the trick. Lost what? Lost wax casting, son. What'd you do? Sleep your way through metal shop? I guess I must have. What's lost wax casting? That's casting with an apostrophe, sonny, not an ing. Anywho, you can make all sorts of things by making a wax positive, using clay to make a mold, then melting down the metal and pouring it into the mold. To make a mold, you carves whatever you want out of wax, see? That's what we call positive. Once you got the wax positive, you take some clay, see, and you pack the clay all around the positive. You just leave a little hole at the top so you can get the wax out. So now you got your wax inside the clay. Welp, you just heat that sucker up till the wax goes all oozy and you pours the wax out, see? That's the lost wax part, see? Now you got just an empty clay mold, what we call a negative. You smelt down your metal and pour the metal into the negative. Once it hardens up, you can just scrape off the clay and there you are. Did you get all that? No. Well, that's what you restore buttons for, kiddo. Now shamoosh. Alright, so that is way more complicated and ridiculous than I ever thought. Okay, so we have a crucible to melt metal. I don't have any clay, though. It's probably clay around here. There's not clay on this shovel, is there still? That was hilarious. He explained how they do lost metal. There we go. Nope. I can dig up clay with it if I can find it. So they explained lost wax casting to us. This has been a very educational in the arcane arc. I think they still use that for different things, but it's been a very educational game in sort of the arcane arts here. Alright, so where would clay be? Probably near the river. There's sand.
Said get!
Get on out. Wow, he's walking fast. Alright. I'm checking near the river first. That just makes the most sense. Meanwhile, the blacksmith might have done... Okay, so let's slow down. So, can we go in here? There's no need to touch that. You know it does no good to close the barn door once the smithy's gone away. Yeah, but what if he had... I feel like he would have had some... Okay. I feel like he would have had some wax, though. Smithy keeps some hay baled up here just for while the horses are in the shop. Can I grab some hay? I've never tried to grab... Hay is for horses! Aww. Anything else interesting? Now it rivals the Oregon's trail and it's just about as smooth. Oregon Trail! Once Corsfield's brave pioneer settlers predict Main Street would rival the... Okay. Heard it again. I don't need to... I need to see if there's wax... not wax. I'm getting confused. I need to see if there's clay around, guys. Clay! Why is there sheep there? Let's talk to this girl. Morning, say, I remember playing right here this very bridge when I was your age. What a liar you are. You were born in old St. Louis. Oh, yeah? Yeah, I listened to the prologue like everybody else. In fact, I can't get the darn thing out of my head. I've been hearing it in my sleep. Thanks loads. Alright, why is there sheep out there? How nice. Clarice, one of the Reverend's sheep, is grazing the grass where the horses once frolicked. No doubt the Reverend, sooner or later, will have both sheep for dinner. Both at the same time? That's a lot of sheep, guys. Reverend Hallelujah replaces horses with sheep. Maybe it's their day. Perhaps it's their day in the sun. Alright, so... I just want to check and see. I'm doing this. The rusty tracks of the fishing camp Pacific Railroad used to continue across the trestle. Okay. Train doesn't come here anymore. No more lumber shipments. No more ice deliveries. No more personal hygiene products. Interesting. All right, let me save it real quick. Because I don't want to have to redo that conversation with Willie. I mean, I might need to just to get any clues, but I think I got it all. Okay, so we're hunting for clay. Aiken? No, just regular clay. All right. Here we go. This is kind of looking suspicious, too. I just want to check the other side so I can walk across the max amount of times and cause myself a problem later. It's fine. All right. The old bridge. Woo! That was a close one. Considering the condition of this old bridge, you only have about 3 crossing left. I keep saying that, but I've crossed like 6 times. Cliffs here drop off sharply, plummeting dramatically to the water below. A guy could get killed walking off there. You make a mental cliffs note to avoid doing so. Well, then you do better than Graham in the other Sarah game, King's Quests. What King's Quest? This game is starting to mess with my grammar and my accent. What's he doing? Hey, Hop! Freddy, but why? Well, Mom's closed and I hear the streets of San Francisco are paved with snails. So I'm going to make my unique blend of culinary experience, specializing in traditional American frontier fare, executed with a Near Eastern blend of herbs and spices, and quaint rustic Chinese movie dialect, and open a restaurant with my old partner, Dap Dance? Oh no, sing and dance together again! Well, take care, Hop. Good luck to you. Same to you, Freddy. Hey, Hop. I'm out of here. Okay, does he have... Okay, I got that, but... Okay, Oh, he's leaving. It looks like Hop Singh is headed out of town along with his student, Kwai Chang Grasshopper. Where's his student? I don't see any student. Okay, so he just left? Okay, famous floppy disk mines. Okay, is this clay? The local has been thriving. What is this over here? I want to see if I can just pick up some dirt. Let me do this. The road is dusty and uninformative. Spin of clay. You really have no desire to touch that anthill, nor do you wish to further your entomological collection at this time. Okay. Desert and sky are much too far away for you to feel anything except a rapidly approaching sunburn. Okay, so I saw... I need to, like... You're not thirsty for cactus now. Maybe I will be later. Maybe they'll tie me up and try and roast me in the sun, in which case I'll need a lot of cactus. Alright, so we need to get some clay. Where's some... Maybe with... There's the weird... Only about 3 crossings. You've said that for like 16 crossings. Here we go. So we need to find... some clay. Oh, you know, there might be some under the water pump. Like, soft enough to deal with. Alright, so Mom's cafe is closed. We closed her down, guys. We closed her down by making her restaurant a health hazard. Let me just see, it's locking up again. There we go. It's a little suspicious that if I touch it with the mouse, it stops locking up. Alright. Where are we? Let's go around and see if we can get some clay. Oop. Was there anything in there that we needed, by the way? You don't need any more. Activated charcoal. Okay, just want to make sure there's no clay. Knowledge. Okay. I'm just looking through here. I'm clicking through the game's puns really fast. Yeah. I'm gonna assume This is the east portion of Bluff Street, so named for a scenic collar of bluff. Okay, well, let me see if I can get any of this dirt down here. Okay, let's open this up then. Let's just let this open up and see what happens. My rope is still stuck up there. You wash your hands, feeling almost entirely unfamiliar to you. Okay, well, I thought I could make... fine. I thought I would have clay underneath there that would be malleable. Oh, I don't want to... I don't want this kind of clay. Because look, there's like different... I don't want outhouse clay, guys. I don't want outhouse clay. Alright, so... grave soil, then? This was a horror movie. This would be when things took a really bad turn. There's like... alright, let me see. Okay, I don't need to know where the street goes. I need to know where I can get some clay. You take Bluff Street and put it in your pocket. Sorry, just bluffing. No, I want... okay, never mind. You're just a jerk. That's all I have to say about that. Is there any clay? Like, did anyone dig up any clay? Oh, I forgot to check the other end of town with the weird stuff. Take some of this.
Score!
Yes! Okay, I'm assuming that's because I clicked through everything. I'm assuming that is clay? Clay from a gravesite. Now if you only had some Eye of Newton bat's tongue, you could probably reanimate a corpse. Why, thank you. That doesn't seem creepy at all. Let's go. So we need clay and we need metal. We have all those keys. I bet we'll be fine. We can just melt down all the keys. That's what we'll do. We'll see what it says when we get there. Oh, I should probably save it. Just wait till it crawls over to the side of the screen. Alright. Opening that tap must do something, but I don't know what yet. Alright. Save! We found the clay in the grave. Save! Alright. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. Here we go. Alright, let's see if we can make this into an ear, guys. But I still have to make the wax softer. I do have something to carve with? Alright, I'm going to figure this out. I didn't think about that part. Do I need to carve an ear? You return! Yes, it's good to see you too. Not dead yet. Okay. So I need to like... so I need to... the way this is painted, it looks like he wet his pants. Noting the classiness of this game. Alright, so... just look at my stuff. I didn't really think about the fact that... I don't have anything to really... carve with, do I? I mean, I have some keys. Am I gonna be carving with keys? Maybe. There's no advantage to waxing the key. No, I wanted to carve the key. Okay. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna need... let me see if I can get Willie to give me that... his whittling, his whittling knife, his knife that he does the whittling with, because it's so whittling like. If anybody's lurking, feel free to say hi, and if you haven't hit follow yet, please hit follow because it helps me out. Thank you. Mind the store, Serena. I'm off to uphold justice and stuff. Ookie the dookie. Alright, so we need a knife, and Willie's got a knife. Maybe they're even selling knives. Alright, let me see. Boom, boom, boom. door swings open from the back of your chest, or say, "Help yourself, we'll be right out." Oh, Willie's not there anymore.
Score!
Oh, ha 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 ha. You pick up Whitlin Willie's knife just to borrow a while. Yay! Hi, Spencer. Spencer says, "Hey, Jen." Hang on, let me just... Actually, I need to move chat because I kind of bumped it and now it's obscured. Okay, there we go. Now I can see again. Alright. Here we go. You came in just in time to see me whittle an ear. Because that's my disguise, is having two ears. Spencer said, "Got your message. Not sure I'm getting filtered. Could be Illuminati." I think it's because you return. Yep. All right. Same conversation we have 30 times a day. He's always shocked every turn. I think it's because I noticed there was... I looked through all my profile stuff and I had... It was automatically checked to filter people I don't know. But it shouldn't have filtered you because you've hit follow on my stream and stuff. Spencer, my emotes for the channel got approved. If you want to see, use them. No pressure. Hey, here's the deal. I could not figure out how to find them. I did all kinds of things. I'm like, I can't find them anywhere. So I haven't even seen them yet, and I was very excited about them. I wanted to see how they looked and stuff, but I could not find them. So, I don't know. You're gonna have to give me clear, like, just directions, I guess. Alright, hang on. Let me whittle this ear. It's whittling time! With your newly acquired skills, you whittle the candle wax into the shape of an ear, one that should theoretically attach snugly to the small knot of cartilage that remains of your original ear. Oh. I don't like the way that says remains of your original ear. Spencer, no prop. Ew, where's the warning on the box that says, "Warning, this game contains references to small knots of cartilage"? That is exactly what I was thinking. Having inadvertently gunked up the knife with good and proper with wax, you toss it away, hoping that Willie finds it sooner or later and thinks he stupidly dropped it. You don't need to toss it away. I think we're going to need a knife later, game. Alright, so now we get to do lost wax casting, which the game helpfully taught us how to do. You carefully pack the clay in and around the wax ear, leaving some of it open so you can pour the wax out later. Alright, so we've got to heat up... No. I'm not exiting. Why does it want me to exit? I don't want to exit. There we go. Alright, what I want to do is try and put... Spencer, do you have BTTV? I did get... That's one of the things I did when I was trying to figure it out. And I added it to my Chrome. So I do have that. I did turn it off. I don't think it had anything to do with this, but I had a lot of trouble at the beginning of the stream with several of the different servers, like, kicking me off, like, almost instantly. So I turned it off, it didn't help, but then I forgot to turn it back on again, and then the stream started working, so we're fine. But I do have it, yes. Alright. Let me see if I can melt down these keys. What key is this? This is my desk key. I think I can melt this down safely, just stop locking. No, I want to pick it up and put it in the crucible. See? Okay. Hit okay. The crucible's only for melting pure, almost pure metals. Oh, hang on. Are we going to have to melt the... We're going to have to melt the church key? Okay, what's it made out of, though? Door to your pharmacy? The key to your safe... Okay, I don't know. One of these keys has got to work. We don't really need these anymore. Pure, almost pure metals. Key to the church. Okay, I tried the safe deposit box key. Let's just try. I want to try all the keys before I go hunting for some mysterious metal. Okay, it says only pure metals, so I have to get like probably like a silver. Okay, hang on. Solid and heavy. This seems like it would be like brass. Almost pure metals. Alright, so let me try this. Did I try this key already? The door key's got a nice ring to it, but I'm bump. All right, I don't have anything else that's metal. I don't know if I read this, Spencer, already, but it would consume CPU power but not interfere in the servers because those are an external factor. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it wasn't saying high encoding when it was kicking me off. Like, it was literally, everything was fine. It would stream for like a tiny bit and then kick me off. So I saw on Reddit that other people have had this problem. I don't know. I eventually found a server that wouldn't kick me off, but I did turn it off. So until I tried it out again some other time, I'm not 100% sure that wasn't causing a problem. All right, so I need to find, do I have any metals in here? Oh, I probably do. Hang on, let's look. Bismuth, well, I don't want to have, okay. I feel like I have a metal in here somewhere for something. Mercuric, that's mercury probably. That doesn't seem like it'd make a good ear though. Calcium carbonate. Magnesium? Would that work? It's like, nope. The crucible only for melting pure, almost pure metals, so that's not gonna work. Medicine bottles, prescription boxes, water, phenol, sodium bicarbonate, no pure. 5 gram measuring spatula. I just wanna make sure I'm not missing any, like, something small in metal. Pill machine, alcohol lamp. There's no big lump of metal that says melt me. All right, so it's pretty awesome. We have our setup. This game teaches you some cool stuff. So this is ready. Oh, they got the wax like dripping out of the ear like earwax. So this is ready for us to melt ourselves a new metal disguise ear, which I thought, kind of think is hilarious because I think the fact that I would have like one metal ear. I'm gonna go upstairs and just make sure I don't have any gold cufflinks or something sitting up here. Would make it more suspicious that I'm the one-eared pharmacist. Like, the wax you could make look like an ear and it looks somewhat realistic, but a shiny metal ear, I don't know. Just make sure there's nothing up here. Your grooming aids. Swedish lice, leather pupinoid. Okay. There's no... So make sure if there's any kind of cufflinks or something that I get them and melt them down. Just open this up. Anything in there, game? There's nothing left in the drawer you can use. And so you tripped and knocked out. Okay, fine. Old glass, fronted bookcase. Thoracic Park by Michael Crouton. A brief history of slime. Diabetics. Nasal passages. Alright, here we go. Oh, was that a brass bed? Would they let me take one of the knobs off and melt it down? Like, I don't need that much. Okay, let me see. They'll let me take, I just wanna make sure before I, no, I'm not trying to sleep. I'm trying to take a, like, I'm trying to get a small bit of metal here. Okay, anything in here that could be helpful? I think I got everything the first time, but you never know. Some of these games. Alright. Let me make sure. Is there anything up here that... Cozy... Okay. I don't need to see all the books. But I do need to see... I do need to see... If there's any kind of, like... I don't know. Cufflinks or ring or engagement ring he hid. Or silver earrings or... Okay. What about over here? Is there anything over here? I just want to make sure before we get out there, because I have a feeling... It's a picture of some nearby big rock. Okay, never mind. Alright, let's go out and see if we can find... We just need to find a little bit of semi-precious or precious metal. Oh, what's this? That's new, isn't it? Let me see if this, that looks like, it's not new, but it looks like silver. I don't want it to, let me, can I please, let me out. In this game. All right. Can you take this? Because this looks metal.
Score!
Yes. You take virtually take the medallion off the wall, thinking Serena will never miss it. Freddy Pharkas, what an entirely unsatisfactory afterlife are you doing with my finely earned silver medallion? I'm going to a good cause, Serena. It's going to help me make Korskol a safer, saner place to live. I'm hoping so, Freddy, for all our sakes. We're going to have a silver ear, guys. I think we're going to be pretty recognizable. Alright, here we go. Here we go! It makes me so happy, all the little science-y things I get to do. Alright, so here's the crucible. I didn't remember about that metal, and I should have, because I think there was a clue from earlier on. But I just saw it, and it looked like, hey... Okay, I meant to pick it up, not touch it. It's too close together here. Oh, just let me do that. All right. I don't think it's melted or anything yet, but we'll see. The silver medallion slowly begins to melt. The medallion is nearly completely melted now. You now have a crucible containing molten silver, and you're holding it in your bare hands. Man, they should call you Silver Hands. All right, so... Okay, why isn't it letting me... Okay. Where's the crucible? Guys, it disappeared. Resulting in empty ear-shaped mold, hot doggy, and a waxy tabletop, but that's not important right now. Okay, so... Where's the crucible? Is it in my possessions? Nope. Okay, so now I have the empty ear. Where's the crucible? Where's the crucible of molten silver? Where is it, guys? It just disappeared. I don't know where it went. Okay, hang on. Let's move this. Oh. Okay, so I have it here. There we go. I had it in my hand with this in my... It doesn't make any sense. Don't worry about it. You quickly pour the molten silver into the empty mold. Just doesn't work like that. Okay, so... Can we look at it now that it's in here? Okay. Your ear mold is now filled with molten silver from your ward medallion. You know, they're not going to censor any another one of these medallions. Is it cooled yet? Can we, like, break it apart?
Score!
Yay! You scrape off the clay and discard it, leaving you with a gleaming silver ear. Beautifully done. With an ear like this, you could, dare I say it, rule the world! Yeah, ha, 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 ha. All right, we can get dressed now. Yay! Gotta love it. I love how the game thinks the silver ear is much more or less... It's not gonna give him away, guys. There's only one-eared guy in town, but I'm sure the guy with the new silver ear is not a problem. All right. So let's see if we can... You keep those, Freddy Pharkas. You can help me look like a, they can help you look like a real Western hero. All right, so okay.
Score.
Yes. With your boots, your clothes, your guns cleaned and loaded, your silver ear, and your lucky neckerchief, you're ready to get dressed and assume your identity as the gunslinging stranger. You return to your penthouse suite, high atop the glittering Pharkas Pharmacy in beautiful downtown Korskol. There, Serena greets you and solemnly assists you in the final preening. It's a somber, yet somehow exciting event. There you are, Freddy Pharkas. You are mostly indeed a picture of stately, mysterious strangeness. Noble will be a positive to recognize you in any way now. Look at him, guys. Thanks for your help. Serena, Korskol owes you a debt of gratitude. It can never repay. If anyone asks, Freddy Pharkas has left town, and if I don't come out of this alive, the pharmacy is yours. You better hope he dies. That is of a true generous nature you are displaying, Freddy. Pharkas, as for me, I would like to open a pharmacy on the reservation among my people, but whether that is fated to be or not is the hands of someone who is not I. Luck be with you, Freddy Pharkas. I am proud now. Here we go. Hooray! Showdown at the Hallelujah Corral. Can we just... This is locking up. Stop locking up. There we go. The stage was set for Freddy's showdown. Wait, did I say slowdown? I meant showdown. I read it as showdown. No, I did say showdown, didn't I? I thought I did. I wasn't sure. Anywho, now that Freddy was wearing his silver thang and his gunslinging duds, nobody except in Serena recognized him. Not even Sadie Overy or Penelope knew who he was. They thought Freddy had skipped town. And they thought this new guy was just a handsome, silver-eared stranger who happened to be especially up on his pharmacology. Now, Freddy didn't have a lot of time to lose because things in Coarse Gold were getting worse and worse. There's nobody left, practically. He's looking good. Alright, let me save it real quick. Hello, we are... Replace. The Silver Stranger. There we go. Replacing that. Looking over Chadwick. Okay, Spencer's giving me a bunch of directions for... Hopefully we'll have some streaming emotes, which would be cool. Just scroll on the bottom. Okay, cool. Thank you. Thank you, Spencer. I will check those out after this stream. I appreciate all the work you put into it. Okay. Oh. They're just throwing more pee out the window. That's always a good idea, right? Alright. Here we go. Oh, hang on. Every time I move something else, like, the OBS is making me paranoid because it keeps locking up, so I want to be able to see the little preview screen. Alright. So here we go. We are officially gunslingers. We are officially in Coarse Gold. Nobody knows who we are. You know. Oh, who's this dude? I love how fast he moves. It looks so funny. Hoping Chester won't recognize you with your new disguise, you approach him with a friendly smile. Say, partner, that's a woeful little sign you're carrying there. We'll polish ears for stagecoach fare. What's the problem? Why so down on your luck? Well, I'll tell you. Even though I don't usually talk to silver disguised strangers, there's a man inside who's the best old guard-darn poker cheat I've ever seen. I never even knew he was stealing from my store till it was all over. You see, I bet everything I own, including my store, on a queen high straight flush. And that son of a gun was holding the king high. Don't feel bad, fella. I would have probably done the same. By the way, did you get this gambler's name? Name sure did. Wheaton Hall is his name, but everybody calls him Aces, and I can see why. Thanks for your time, and I hope things work out for you. I think I might just pay Mr. Aces a little call. I love how he's looking a big star now. He's like, good luck to you, stranger, if you are gonna get into that game. Okay. Thanks, I'm wearing my lucky neckerchief, so I'm not too worried. Sure, alright. Alright, Spencer says, you're very welcome. They were fun to make. I'll post a link or two if you want to see them real quick. I don't dare because I've had so much trouble. I'm worried that if I try and, like, click on a link that my whole thing is going to come collapsing down around me like a house of cards. Alright, so we got to figure out this poker game over here. Oh, I went one step too far. The poker game's right here because I was right at the saloon. Here we go. We're gonna go in and see what's going on. Whoop, whoop. I love when we go to a new act. Oh, wow. Let's talk to everybody. So many people to talk to. So many NPCs. Oh. Oh, clicking through too fast. How could you let this scoundrel swindle people out of their homes and life savings? And you are... I'm Fry! Wait a minute! No, never mind, you don't know me. But the folks of Coarse Gold are losing their shirts, this lying, thieving, cheating, low-down, no-good, scum-sucking drifter. Please, sir, don't talk that way about the saloon's new owner. I just work here now. If you have any complaints or suggestions, feel free to put them in writing. I'll be happy to pass them along to the new management. So let me try this again. Sam, what the devil is going on here? Do I know you? How could you let... Okay, there we go. Now I backed up the point. I just don't want to skip anything, because sometimes they give clues, and you're click, 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 clicking through. Who's this dude? Howdy, stranger new in town? Hi, sure am, and I'm looking for a hot time. Oh. I've been noticing some of your fine, coarse, cold fillies, and I wouldn't mind an introduction. Perhaps you could put in a good word for me with one of them. Of course, I know a lot of you boys gotta pay for your fun, but I figure a guy with my looks and breath, hey, they should be paying me, you know, right? Right. By the by, my name is Laffer Zircon, Jim Laffer. Don't believe I caught yours. Whoops, I think I can smell something burning or something. Catch you later. Woo, what rock did he crawl out from under? Okay, guys. How's the game going, Slick? Who wants to know? Just interested. Well, it's going very nicely, Justin. I've won the deeds to the saloon, the cafe, the school, and several other plots of land. My employer would be pleased. I should have the rest of the town sewn up in a few minutes. Who's your employer? Sorry, that information is covered under the terms of boss huckster privilege. Alright. Let me save it real quick in case it's a mini game where we play poker and I lose. Gambling man! Oops, replace. I have to hit the replace before I can do anything with it. Gambling man. Place. I'm seeing the link, Spencer, but I'm not seeing the image. But I will take a look at it in a minute. Alright, hang on. So, let's say I want to play. You don't want to start playing poker with this guy. He's known far and wide as a cheat. In fact, if you could catch him red-handed, you might be able to stop him before he wins away every last piece of property in town. Okay, what am I seeing here? Okay, how can I catch him cheating? Aces is holding his cards tightly. One of his hands appears unusually stiff. Maybe he's nervous? Oh, I saw that! Okay. I don't know if the minigame... It appears to be a third hand, so that's how Ace is cheating. Okay, so what do I do about that, though? Oh, I've got to catch it. Don't touch my card, Silver Boy. I wouldn't want to be accused of cheating.
Score!
Got it! You're cheating. That's a fake left hand. Your real hand is hidden under the table. You've been feeding good cards in your hand and taking away the bad ones. Why, yes, silver-eared stranger, you're correct, almost. As you see, I have no cards in my left hand. I only have this. Ooh. Turn around, silver ear. I think I'd rather shoot you in the back so I don't have to see the ugly face of yours. Where's our gun? Ooh. Okay, so we did that. That's cool. Alright, wrong thing. Just save it quick. Save it! We're in a bad spot. Save it from... fight! 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 Just in case this goes terribly bad. Alright. So, come here. Come on, game. I'm really worried about how this stuff goes. Alright. I need to get my guns out and use them. What does that do? Okay, they're all moving away. Gotta use our guns. Woo! Oh, I died. Well, you got to admit the fellow died trying to defend his town. Now, we all kind of had to leave town or get shot up anyways, so it's not as if Freddy done any real good, but we were still exciting to have him around for a while. I guess this story don't end so good. Let me see. Have I told you the one about the traveling band uniform salesman and the librarian? Well, it seems there was trouble in River City and they had a pool table in. Rest in pieces. Alright. Hang on, let me see. I want to see the, I want to see the emote. Let me see if it'll... Ah, don't mess anything up. I'm waiting while I'm sitting here resting in pieces. Oh, that's really cool. Okay, it just kicked me off. Dang it! Alright, my back, hopefully. It just kicked me off when I tried to look at it. Sorry, I'm not gonna look at it anymore. I'll look at it later. It was like, nope. Okay, I think we're back. Hey, this is Jim with glasses, and we're back. Alright, let's try this again. So, we need to do a better job. Spencer says, oh shoot. Well, you know, I told you I wasn't gonna look at him, and then I decided to look at him. It's my own fault. All right. Bum, bum, bum. All right, so... What do we got? So shooting him immediately gets us killed. What do we have to do here? We don't have anything. Okay. Hang on. Well, I don't know. Can we throw these cards at him as a distraction? Doesn't work like that. Okay, so what's the deal? Did we not shoot well enough? Or did it just, like, try and kill us? Okay, what are we trying to shoot here? Okay, let's try this again. Okay, that doesn't work. Well, you got to admit the fellow died trying to defend his town. Oh, boy. Did not do well. Spencer, sorry, I'd love to hear your expression. It looks really cool. I really like the good gravy one. Restore. Fight! Fight, fight, fight! You did a very good job of the gravy boat. I thought that was pretty cool. Alright, so hang on. Let's see. If I shoot him, he shoots me back. So... Alright. Can I shoot the chandelier? Nope, I still die. So I'm not supposed to shoot him. I'm not supposed to shoot the chandelier in some sort of, like... So I've got this up. Let me look around. Goodness, the saloon sure filled up fast. Practically the whole town's gathering to see you die a bloody death. I mean, to see you bring aces to justice. Wheaton Aces Hall, the infamous riverboat gambler, seems to have you under a barrel. How peculiar. Why would a riverboat gambler, especially one as successful and popular as Aces, come to a two-bit burglar like Coarse Gold? This can't be a coincidence. Someone must have sent him a wire. But why? And how? Our telegraph office closed down 2 weeks after it opened. Alright, so... Goodness, the saloon sure filled fast. Okay. So there's gotta be a solution to this problem. Okay. So... Give yourself up, Aces. I caught you red-handed. Never! Not gonna do it. Nope, wouldn't be prudent at this juncture. But I caught you. Yes, but I ain't going nowhere if I can help it. And I warn you, if you shoot me in cold blood, you'll hang! Of course, why wouldn't he hang? Yeah, I saw that. Spencer says, Twitch seems to be frozen. You might be dropping frames. Sorry! Sometimes if I... Alright, let's see now. I'm back. Alright, so talking to him doesn't help. Talking to him doesn't help. There's gotta be... So look, there's people around. Okay, that's not helpful. Okay. I can't pick up anything. I can't move, really. Who's this dude? There's money. Okay, yeah, I know. Someone must have sent him a wire. I can't run out of here. I can only talk. Drop your gun and give up. You can't win. Consider you the one cowering behind a table. Don't you think you should be the one to give up? I'm not cowering. Could have fooled me. Spencer, I don't think I'd be okay with Owl dating my sister. Yeah, I don't think so. I don't think so either. Alright, hang on. So, there's nothing you reach from your strategically rotten position behind this overturned table. Okay, so what do we have in here? Other than a standoff. Where's the creepy guy? Is he still in here? He is. Let me see if I can just throw him these gross postcards. That doesn't work like that. Doesn't work like that. Alright, so no one... I thought I could, like, shoot the chandelier on him. I thought that would be fun. There's nothing you can reach from here strategically. So I just have to shoot something, but if I shoot something, I just die. Alright, so... Okay, we'll be... If I can shoot something from cowering behind the table... Let me see if it'll give me a hint if I'm like... Okay, nope. Under a barrel. Yeah, I know. Why is he here? We know. He shouldn't be here. It's strange. Alright, is there anything back here we can do? Can we throw alcohol bottles at him? That seems like a good idea. Okay, so how can I beat him? What am I not seeing when he shoots there? Rest in pieces. Yes, I know. Why would he? This doesn't make any sense. But you know, things don't make sense. Doesn't make sense why he's here unless someone's paying him to be there. So I can't. Let's see. I can. There's no need to touch that. Okay, I'm in a strategically rotten position. They keep telling me that. Should I have not. They put me in that position. What do I have in here? I have nothing other than postcards and some keys. I throw a key at him? I would just start throwing keys at him. Alright. Is there anything else I can shoot in the room? Like, what if I shot this glass globe thing over here? No, I just die every time. Spencer, people cleared out when there was a gunfight in old westerns. Yeah, because they're smart, because people aren't always that accurate. And, you don't want to die from a stray bullet. But apparently in this game, they all gather around as closely as possible to maximize the collateral damage, I guess. Alright. 792 out of 999. That's pretty good. So, what is the deal with him? He's got... We're in a bad position, because we're... literally cowering behind the table. Let's keep talking to him and see if he's... Because he's been doing... Never! I'm not gonna do it. Nope, wouldn't be prudent at this juncture. But I caught you. Yes, but I ain't going nowhere if I can help it. And I warn you, if you shoot me in cold blood, you'll hang! Alright. Drop your gun and give up. You can't win. Considering you're the one cowering behind a table, don't you think you should be the one to give up? I'm not cowering. Could have fooled me. I'm gonna count to three, and when I reach three, you better have your hands in the air. Oh my, I'm a scared. One. You realize, I hope, that the moment you show your head or any part of your body around that table, I'll shoot you dead. You do know that, don't you? Two. No shirt off my back, of course. The sheriff never arrested me for murder. We're both paid by the same boss, you know. Two and a half. Maybe you better just let me shoot you now. This is painful. Two and seven eighths. not to mention tedious. And you apparently don't understand me. I'll start over. Okay, so we know we're getting more and more information out of him. I'm gonna count to three, and when I reach three, you better have your hands in the air. Oh my, I'm scared. One! You do know that one, too. Two! Don't shoot off my back, of course. Sheriff, they'll arrest me for better. We're both paid by the same boss, you know. Three, two and a half. Maybe you better just let me shoot now. This is painful. 2 7/8. Not to mention tedious. Okay, you apparently don't understand me. I'll start over. So we've gotten more information. I mean, I kind of figured he and the sheriff were being paid by the same guy, but in case we didn't know. Okay, let me just save it to make sure I don't have to keep going through this over and over and over and over again. Bum bum. Alright, so we got our info. So I want to try something, but I don't want to have to go back again. Alright, save icon. Get out of here for a second. Make sure that OBS isn't locking up. Spencer, I didn't know how to contact you, so I made a comment on one of your videos. You might want to make a gaming Twitter account that links to your real one, but doesn't have any personal info on it. Just a thought. No, my husband actually said that to me too. I did see your comment on YouTube, which is why I kind of redoubled my efforts to figure out what was going on with my message box. But yeah, he mentioned that too. He's like, you really need to set up some sort of Twitter account where you can announce things and people can contact you. And I'm like, yeah, I do. So I need to go through and set something up. I'll get it done. Alright, now that we talked to this dude three times, let us see if we can now shoot him. Nope, we still die. Well, you got to meet the failed dad trying to defend his town. Now, we all either had to leave town or get shot up anyway, so it's not as if Freddy done any real good, but it was still exciting to have him around for a while. Now, I guess that story don't end so good. Let me see. Have I told you one of them? Restore. Alright, so I got the... I talked to him three times. I got more and more information out of him, which is what the game wanted me to do. Now, what does the game want me to do? Ba-ba-da-bum, ba-da-bum-bum. So... there's no one else I can talk to. I can't talk to anyone else. Don't ask the townies for help, Freddy. The ball's in your court. Okay. Oh my, I'm scared. It's the same one as before. So that's all the information you can get out of him. What are we gonna do? Because shooting him, like, ends terribly. Hi, Bobadino. Bobadino. Holy cow, I fell asleep watching Bob Ross. That'll happen. You just gotta make those little birds, those little trees, those happy little trees. It just makes you so happy. Spencer says he's relaxing, and Bobadino says, yeah, he is. He is. He's a very non-judgmental artist, which is a rare thing. Alright, okay, so... I remember as a kid when they used to play him all the time on PBS, I would become mesmerized by him. Because it would come on, like, after, like, the last of the children's shows sometimes. And I wouldn't turn the TV off, I would just kind of sit there and fall into the trance of watching him do one of his landscapes. Alright. What am I gonna do here? Okay, so I only have my six shooters, but that's not where... there's all kinds of crazy... what, there's a fireman in the background? Where was he? Where was he when everything was on fire? That's what I want to know. Oh, crud, I gotta move my stuff over. I keep having to move things around. Okay. Here we go. So, what am I gonna do here? I think the TV networks did it on purpose to make all the kids pass out after cartoons. Yeah, they hyped us up on all the cartoons, and then they chill us out with the Bob Ross.
Hi,
Alright. What can I do here? I have these stupid postcards. I am at a really tactical disadvantage. He's just waiting around. He hasn't blown my head off yet. And the game is right. It is tedious to sit here and be like, okay. So, I really want to shoot the chandelier down and have it land on him. That's what I want to do. The game actually gives me like a target, which means I can really specifically target something. But I don't know what to target. Like, by the time I stand up, I'm already dead. Should I shoot him through the, like I like this, gives you a cool little targeting thing. Oh good, you guys can see that. It's locking up a lot, so if I can't complete this in a couple of rounds, I may not be staying on much longer. So let's see, can I target his fake hand? Nope, I still die. Well, you got to admit, the fella died trying to defend his town. Yeah, he did. Too bad he's too dumb to shoot anything or figure out how to shoot anything. He was a sharpshooter, but he can't shoot anything. Bum 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 bum. Alright, so is there anything I can, like... There's nothing you can reach in your strategically rotten position. Yeah, this is a rotten strategic position. Although I would pick up the table and, like, run with it and try and ram him. Try and stand weirdly so he doesn't know where I am behind. I don't know. That's what I would do. Move the overturned table. This is a terrible position. Terrible, terrible, terrible. Spencer, I'm dropping frames like they're going out of style. I know. I don't know. It wasn't quite as bad as that one time a couple weeks ago where it was really, but it's pretty awful. Plus, no one got to. I got like the apple pie tonight. I did all this stuff, and it kicked me off. All right. I wish I could just run out this door. Like, can I just run out the door? I don't have anything cool in my inventory either I can use. If I was close enough to the pool table, I'd just start chucking pool cues at him. All right. So this dude's a weird dude. That dude's a weird dude. He's not even facing me. I mean, I know. Okay. Let's see. I tried to give these to this dude, didn't I? That leisure suit there, dude. That doesn't work like that. Okay, well. Touch me and you'll get a bullet in the heart before you know it. Jeez, talk about homophobia. Oh, Freddy, you just revealed something about your character there, buddy. Alright. Your pistol's clean and loaded for bear. You're cooking now. Your key to your pharmacy. Oh, that's what you should... You should play him for the pharmacy. That doesn't work like that. Spencer, whoa. I know, that was an interesting reference for this time period. Alright. Doesn't work like that. Spencer says there was a line in Gabriel Knight. Alright, I can't use any of my stuff. We're just gonna start trying to shoot him. Let's aim right for the heart. There we go. He's just faster than me. Now I'll have to leave town anyways. Spencer says there was a line in Gabriel Knight. One of his room decorations has probably something left behind by some woman or other. It's that or other makes me think. There you go. Okay. So, what do they want me to shoot? Well, I'm still died every time. Too bad Freddy didn't take some sort of his drugs to speed up his reaction time. Like some sort of limitless drug. Which is just a dumb idea now as it was then. so much time in this room. Like, he's not coming after me. He seems to have you under a barrel. Yeah, I know. But why? But how? How and why? We're not gonna figure that out if we can't get out of this room. I'm gonna count to three, and then I'll reach three. You better have your hands in the air. Oh my, I'm scared. One. You realize, I hope, that the moment you show your head or any part of your body around the table, I'll shoot you dead. You do know that, don't you? Yes, I know that. Two. No shirt off my back, of course. Okay, so it's all the same. This is painful and tedious. I don't know what he wants me to shoot. Like, Spencer, I've done a little research in that field. There's a drug called modafinil that works kind of like that, but the NZT thing is, or its effects are nonsense. Well, first of all, we use more than 10% of our brain. Like, that's not a real thing. We use way more, way more than 10%. I was like, not way more than 100%. But we use most of our brain. Like, that's not a thing. All right, so the game gives me a target thing. I'm gonna shoot the moose. I don't know. He's kneeling down funny too. There's no way we can, like, I would like reach around the bottom and shoot at his feet is what I would do. Well, you guys admit the fellow died trying to defend his town. Now he died. He died. Spencer, monofil provigil, I'm looking into because of school. Well, I would just say anything that you take for anything, just be aware. It doesn't just affect one part of you, it affects everything. There's no magical cure or fix for anything. There's things that are helpful and you make trade-offs, and things that are less helpful and you decide not to make the trade-offs. Alright. I know I'm supposed to shoot with this thing. All right, I'm gonna give myself three more tries. If I can't figure it out, then I'll be done for tonight, and then I'll be back on Thursday, and hopefully I'll figure out what's making the craziness with the server, or maybe the server will be corrected by then. Okay. All right, buddy. I could shoot him right between the eyes. It's not letting me do anything. The cow's head up there. Let me just see if I can spam click it a little bit to see if they just want me to try a couple, like several times until, if they're trying to give me time to get my background information that I need. Spencer, I didn't want to say anything more about it. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, the stream I mean. Oh, okay. There we go. That's it. Okay, restore. Okay, one last time. Bum ba bum bum ba bum bum bum. Okay. So if it's not him, if that fails every time, I feel like I wanted to shoot the chandelier. Like, I wanted this big moose head's in the way, but I wanted to like shoot the rope, which is very impossible. Spencer's, this is when I throw up the all gravy baby. I could shoot this down on myself, but that doesn't make any well, no, would it? I wonder. Oh! Oh, I just killed somebody. Fancy ladies of the night. Alright, so okay, I am gonna please be your kind, rewind. Okay. That's cool though. Okay, so it goes over there. So it hits there. I have to get it to go. Okay. Alright. watch this more carefully, and I'm not. Okay, so when I hit up here, it hits here, and then it hits down there. No. So I, oh boy, I need to like fix that. Remember that in Blockbuster? Yes, I do. I remember having some place that would fine you for like not rewinding correctly. Can I hit it up here and like hit him? No, but anything over there gets me killed instantly. So I was on the right track. Oh, that was cool. Alright, I am gonna keep going because I was on the right track with that. I need to stop killing the lady in the background, but this might be why you leave the saloon when there's a gunfight going on. Alright, so... okay, so when I hit up here... alright, let's try this again. This is the only thing that's done. So it hits here, and it hits her. Please be kind, rewind. Woo! It's going up there. Okay. So if it's hitting here and going here and hitting her. Oh, there's the bank manager. We could just take him out now and save ourselves some time. Alright, so this is the only thing it's let us shoot. Can I... no, it's still in the same part. Alright, so... can I talk to her and tell her to move? Like, get down. So I know, oop, whoa, that was weird to click on. Okay, so I know that if I hit this, it hits her. Maybe I can talk to her and tell her to move. Can you move? Don't ask the townies for help, Freddy, the ball's in your court. Can I like throw something at her? Get down. Oh guys, is it locked up? I bumped it again, hopefully it'll unlock, but still. Alright. And this is really exciting, too. This just... okay. Oops, I don't know what I just did there, but I wasn't gonna see that. Alright, guys. I'm just gonna wrap it up here. I want to stream longer. But it keeps locking up, and there's cool stuff happening. Like, this is what we've been playing the whole game for, to do stuff like this. Like, I spent the whole last act getting stuff together to be a gunslinger, and you can't even get to see me, like, have a gunfight. And, you know... kill a dancer over and over and over again. So, crap. I think I'm gonna sign off for tonight a little bit early, but then I'll be back on Thursday night and hopefully it'll be better. Like, this is a weird thing where my setup's not changed, but whatever else is going on out there, whether it's with my internet provider or whether it's with the Twitch servers, I don't know. But I'm not gonna do this again. I did that with Discworld where I played a lot and it just kept locking up and you guys missed most of the fun stuff, so. Spencer, how about come back if you can fix it? Bo, but you know, have you tried waxing your modem to make it go faster? So I did. I had trouble earlier in the stream, and I did all kinds. Like I got kicked off after like a minute, and then I couldn't get back on. So I did do stuff like reset some things and do some other stuff. I think it's just an issue. Either it's a variable that I don't have direct control over, and I tried everything I can try on my end. So I think, honestly, rather than like try and keep just trying to get it to work tonight, I'm probably gonna be done. Even though I'd like to play more of the game, and this is an exciting part. But what we'll do is I will save it here. I already did save it here, and then when we come back on Thursday, we'll be right here and we'll figure this out. Like, whatever ricochet thing this is, it's trying to show me. Spencer, download more RAM. Bobadino, you know, that's unfortunate. I know, I'm really bummed. I'm trying to get, actually, we got in the mail, and I talked to Verizon about Fios before. We got in the mail this deal, I'm like, that's what we're paying now for crap. And, but they kept saying that we weren't eligible for it. And so I called them. I'm like, you literally sent a mailer to my house saying that sign up for this now. And they're like, yeah, we did. But your address in our computer says you don't get it. And I'm like, really? And they're like, yeah. So I think it probably has to do with the fact that my internet's slow, and some nights it's slower than others, and this is a particular night when it's particularly slow, and between my computer being older and my internet being slower, OBS can't, I just can't compress it. So it's a bummer. It's a real bummer. But I will see you guys on Thursday. Spencer's asked me if there's a wisp. I still haven't looked into that. I need to. I've been busy with other stuff this weekend and week, but I do want to... But I do want to look into that. But, wow, this an adds to your house until you know. What a waste. That's what I said. I'm like, if you've got a computer program that can tell you whether or not my address is eligible, you can't forward that to your ad guys to say, you know, hey, let's not send this ad to people that can't get it. Anyway, that's boring shop talk. But I will see you guys hopefully on Thursday. We'll pick up where we left off, and hopefully I'll have everything like worked out. If anyone's lurking and they haven't hit follow, please hit follow because it helps me out. And check out my YouTube channel if you get a chance. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you for sticking with it, even though it was a little bit crappy quality-wise tonight. I'll see you guys on Thursday. Thank you.